morning, I want to read scripture. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him and he will make your path straight. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you so much for our church. Lord, I thank you for these beautiful children, Lord God, that you've designed for me to be here and help teach them and grow them closer to you, Lord God. I thank you for their hearts, Lord God. And I'm praying hard for the two that are moving in with the teens, Lord God. As they grow in their lives, they grow close to you, Lord. I'm praying that you touch them and give them a spiritual awakening and just get them on fire for you this morning. And Lord God, that my words that I speak this morning are the words that you wanted me to speak this morning, Lord God. That I don't chase rabbits down a trail, that I don't go off of my own little thoughts, Lord, that I stay focused in on you this morning. So this morning, if someone needs to hear this, I pray that these words touch them this morning. And Lord God, if there's someone here that doesn't know you as their Savior, Lord God, I pray that this morning this altar is open. Right now it's open. If you need to know the Savior, I'm praying, Lord, stirs your heart and brings you down this morning. So we ask these things in your Son's precious name. Amen. Now this morning I want to start out with a story. Story about a man. Just a regular guy, just like us, just a regular man. Thought life was doing well. He was went to college, got his degree, working on things. Everything's going great, right? But God had something else in his plans. God had something going on. Now, this man, when he was younger, he came to the Lord. He knew who the Lord was. He knew about how the Lord died for him on the cross for him. Now, this same man also had a call on his life. This man had a call to teach and preach. But through growing up in his life, he started to chase his own dreams and follow his own things. But God had other plans. God's plans are the ultimate plans. And sometimes God has to steer us towards those plans. Now, I'm going to get back to this man in just a second. But I want us to look at a few words this morning. This morning's message is called Trust in Faith. We all need to do that, don't we? We need to trust in faith. We need to have that faith that can move mountains. We need to have that faith that can see cancer destroyed. We need to have that kind of faith. Now, the word trust, I looked it up in the dictionary. It says a firm belief in reliability or strength in someone or something. So we have to trust. Faith. Now, it's interesting. When you look the word faith up, it has that previous word in it. It says complete trust or confidence in someone or something. Trust and faith go together. Like peanut butter and jelly. They go together. You have to have one to have the other. Now this morning, I'd like to have Jason come forward. He said it was okay for me to bring him up. I want us to think about trusting this morning. I'm going to move this out of the way, otherwise I'll take it down. I want you to face out there. Now he's going to put his trust in me. Okay? I want you to go ahead and fall back. Oh, I got it. Now see, what was that an action of? You go ahead and sit down, bud. What was that an action? That was an action. He trusted and had faith that Brother Matt was going to catch him, right? Now, if I would have just lifted my hands and let him hit the ground, would he have that trust anymore? No. He wouldn't have that faith trusting Brother Matt's going to catch him. Now, I did tell Will if he came up here, I probably would drop him. But we have to have that trust and faith go together. Now this morning, I want us to look at a few people in the Bible, in Scripture, that really trusted God, trusted Jesus, and knew, had the faith that he was going to come through. Now let me set the stage if you want to. It's John chapter 6, verses 5 through 15, but I want to set the stage for a minute. During this time, it was a feast of Passover. There were thousands of people. Lots of people. And they were coming, they wanted to hear this Jesus. So they come around, and they got around Jesus. Let me read the scripture here. It says, now the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was at hand. Lifting up his eyes then, and seeing the large crowd was coming toward him, Jesus said to Philip, I like that. Jesus knows everything, doesn't he? He already knows what's going to happen. He looks to Philip. Where are we to buy bread so that we may for these people may eat? Jesus knew this. He knew the answer before even. He was testing and asking Philip here. He said to test him, for he himself knew that he would do what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 denarii worth of bread would not be enough for each of them to get a little. And then one of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, there is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they for so many?" Jesus said, having the people sit down, now there was much grass in this place, so the men sat down and were about 5,000 in number. Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those that were seated, so also the fish, as many had wanted. And when they had eaten their fill, he told the disciples to gather up the leftover fragments, that nothing may be lost. So they gathered them up and filled the 12 baskets with fragments of the 5 barley loaves left that they have eaten. Now the people saw this sign that they had done and said, "This indeed is a prophet. Who is it who had come into this world?" Now I want us to look at this young man this morning. A boy's lunch. Simple thing. We have a dilemma. Jesus, look at all these people. Well, how can we feed them? And Philip, what do you answer? We don't, even 200 denarii would not be enough to buy for them just to eat a little. Jesus knew before this. He knew the child was going to come with his lunch. Now that child had to have some trust there, didn't he? That child had to know that, hey, this is a little, but I know that Jesus can take care of it. I know that Jesus is going to handle it and take care of it. Now it's interesting in that scripture, Jesus knew what he was going to do. He knew that it would be enough. Have you ever felt like you don't have enough? Right? When the bills all come in at the end of the month, it seems like there's too many bills and not enough money to pay them. Maybe it seems like just your spiritualness. Maybe that's you got a lot of things going on in your life. Life is just terrible. You got, let's just say, sickness. Your health is awful. You need more faith. You need more trust. Now in 8 and 9, the boy had, he comes forward. He says, I have 2 fish and 5 loaves. Can you see the disciples? He said it right there. He says, what is this for so many? Sometimes we need to trust God and go with what we got. We need to come to God with what we have, because guess what? He can take what we have and he can touch some lives like these young kids. He can take our testimony. Maybe we dealt with drug addiction or we've dealt with problems and different things. So we could do what we've dealt with and we could help other people. We could take it to Jesus and he can take it. But what are they for so many? Do we doubt God sometimes? I want you to deep down think about that. Do we doubt God sometimes? This is the same God that created the universe, the same God that knows the hairs on your head, even though some of it says a lot less. It's the same God that knows how many children you're going to have. It's the same God that knows the color of their eyes of each child you have. But do we really trust and have that faith in him when it comes to things in our life? Do we have faith that God's going to take care of the problems? Do we trust that God's in control? This is a giant dilemma. There's no food for the people. They're hungry. And the little boy says, well, take what I have. And Jesus says, watch this. He blessed it. And it went out. Now these same men, Simon, Andrew, Philip, all these men follow Jesus. They were with Jesus. They've seen some miracles. But what was the response? What is this for so many? That sounds like us, doesn't it? What can I do? How can I help? I'm just a simple person. I don't speak very well. I'm nervous. God can use that. These same men who saw these miracles had a problem with their trusting him and their faith in him. We all have doubts sometimes, don't we? Can we all raise our hand? We all have doubts sometimes. Sometimes when life just sucks and it seems like one thing after another, a flat tire after a flat tire maybe, or other things, it just seems like it just keeps attacking you. Or maybe you're in the hospital every other week and you're tired of the hospital food. Sometimes it seems like stuff just overwhelmingly hits you. And we all go through times where we go, it's too much. It's hard. We doubt God can really take care of it. What we see in verse 10 and 10 through 12, the power of God showed up. Let me read that. The power of God showed up, 10 and 12, 10 through 12. And Jesus said, have the people sit down. Now there was much grass in that place. And the men sat down, about 5,000 number. Now that's the interesting thing, 5,000. Thinking about 5 loaves of bread for our group here and 2 fishes. I don't think we could feed everybody, right? It's interesting. I can imagine Jesus is saying, Jesus is in his mind is going, watch this. This is how amazing God is. Watch this. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them, and that were all that were seated, so also fish as they wanted. And when they had eaten their fill, he told the disciples, gather up the leftover fragments so that none would be lost. Jesus knew that that small amount that that young man came to them with, that there's going to be more. There's going to be more. Don't think that what you do is minimal for the service of God. I'm so thankful we have awesome musicians that play. Don't ever think that it's a minor thing, because God's using you. Maybe it's raising your children at home. Deuteronomy 6 tells us that we need to be the mission field with our own kids. Don't ever look down on that. Don't ever think, well, it's just a minor thing. I'm teaching my kids. It's the biggest thing. Teaching a Sunday school class, it's a big deal. You have kids running crazy, silly things. My Sunday school class, nobody could name a song that they would use for praising. It's funny. We all know the songs we sing. We love, right? Whom Shall I Fear? I love that. Danny Gokey's song, he sings Tell My Heart to Beat Again. We know these songs. All these different things that touch our lives. We need to be excited to use what God's given us. If that's to teach, give it to the Lord. If you think it's a minor thing, come to him, watch what he can do with it. God can take tiny things and make them ginormous. And we don't have to have a mega church, right? God can use us here, because guess what? We have folks right here, right around this church that are hurting, that maybe need with that little bit of offering that we can give to the Lord and go across and talk to them. Maybe that little bit of saying, Lord, I trust you, and you just go forward and you talk to them. They need to hear something this morning. Maybe they need to hear about Jesus, because they could be on a road right now that's sending them straight to the pit of hell. And I believe hell is a real place, and we got people dying every day going to it. We have to trust that our God is able to give us the courage to speak to somebody. Don't be afraid. Have faith. We just finished the book of James on Wednesdays. Whole book about being doers of the word, not hearers only. And a lot of the scripture hit us hard as Christians. Give the Lord what we have, because he can turn it around and make it amazing. The power of God showed up. Sometimes we feel like we are at our weakest. When we're at our weakest, that's when God shows up. God shows up when we're at our weakest. So if today you're going through a tough time in your life, I'm gonna be honest with you. I was joking with Josh this morning about texting him and saying, I can't preach because I'm in the hospital again. It's really not a joke for me, because in reality, I could have been, because I'm always in for issues for my stomach and things. But I told my wife this morning, I trust God. He's going to get me through it today. He's going to get me through preaching, because this is what I want to do. I wanted to hand Jason his certificate. I wanted to hand Levi his certificate, because I love these kids. I want to be here and share the word that God's given me. I want to trust him enough to know that I'm going to get through this. I have a doctor's appointment tomorrow. I can get to that doctor's appointment. Don't need to go to the hospital, because it's like a mini vacation home is what I tell everybody. I'm always there. I had to trust God this morning, saying, I'm going to go, I'm going to have my faith in you, and I'm going to preach your word that you've given me. We need to think about what God has been speaking to us. Each and every one of us have something. We're not just people who come and fill a pew, folks. We are called on a commission. We're on a mission. God wants us to do something. If you just come to church and warm a pew and go home and maybe read your Bible some, we're missing out on so much. We're missing out on so much. This young boy who heard, I'm sure, this young boy heard all these stories of Jesus, how he cured folks, how he turned the water to wine, and how he did all these things. I could see this young boy saying, it's yours, Lord. Show me something. Here, Lord, this will, I know you can make this work. We have to have that faith and trust that he will make it work, folks. Kids, you're getting ready to go back to school. You have that trust in the Lord, because guess what? Satan's going to attack you guys. Have your faith in him. Trust him that he's going to get you through it. Trust him this morning. This morning, I want to look at another person. I want to talk about a woman who had a blood disorder. That's in Luke chapter 8. It's funny, when I was reading this and studying this, this one kind of sits close to me. Let me read it to you. Luke chapter 8, verses 43 through 48. It says, and Jesus went to the people and pressed all about him. And there was a woman who had a discharge of blood for 12 years. And though she had spent all her living on physicians, She could not be healed by anyone. She came up behind him and just touched the fringe of his garment, and immediately the discharge of blood had ceased. And Jesus said, "Who was it that touched me?" When all denied it, Peter said, "Master, the crowds surround you and are pressing in on you." But Jesus said, "Someone touched me, for I perceived the power had gone out of me." And when the woman had saw that she was not hidden, she came trembling and falling before him and declared in the presence of all the people why she had touched him, how she had been immediately healed. And he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace." I wish that I could just, if Jesus was in here, he's here with us, folks, right now. I wish I could touch a garment this morning and this would all just heal up. I have faith that God's getting me through the issues. But think about it. She spent all of her money on physicians, right? All of her money, and she knew in her mind, she had that trust. All she had to do is touch that garment. Touch that garment. You can touch that garment today. You can touch that garment today. All you have to do is believe and trust, have that faith that God's going to take care of you. I've seen cancer destroyed here. I've seen people healed. I've seen some miraculous things. I've seen a woman hit by a car, crushed by a car, whose leg was gone, pretty much crushed, who can walk in her church this Sunday and she can sing to the Savior. I've seen amazing things happen. We have to reach out and touch that garment. Let me get back to that man in the beginning of the story. Regular man, right? Just like you and me, right? I'm sure he has arthritis, deals with issues. Probably argues with his wife all the time about certain kinds of what music they like. Guess what? That man is me. I have been through the ringer. I hate bringing up about me, but I just want to share something with you. I've seen what the Lord can do, folks. Kids, look up here. I know we talk about it in the back, about my car wreck and what happened. And I don't care about the car wreck. It got me closer back with Him. See, I was doing great. I thought I was doing awesome in my life. I was working for a rich man, working every Sunday, though. God called me to preach. But God had other plans. God may have a plan for your life. Teenagers, God does have a plan for your life. Kids, God does have a plan for your life. And that's to trust Him, number one, and follow where He leads you. If that's into ministry, we will bathe you in prayer. If that's just witnessing your friends, we'll bathe you in prayer. Do I understand God's will? No. Sometimes we can't understand it, right, Brother Gary? Sometimes it seems like God's will doesn't make sense. Why some of us have to go through medical issues or cancer or problems or divorce or different things. God's will, we don't get it sometimes. We get frustrated, right? Who gets frustrated? Get ready for church and your tire's flat. I'm going to pick on that one for a little bit. It gets frustrating, but God's there. God's in control. Or we go through this, because here's what I go through. I admit it, I got a pity party. Why me, why me, why me? In both stories of Scripture, I should still be on camera. In both stories, we see God does something amazing. But because of, why was it so amazing? Because there are two people in them stories, right? We had the boy. That boy had to trust that Jesus was going to do something. That woman with the discharge of blood knew that she had to do something. Touch his garment. The young man knew that he had to take his lunch and give it to Jesus. This message this morning, I'm focusing on you, on the teens and the kids this morning. God has something for you, folks. Has something for you guys. Don't think that it's just to be a Christian, to just go to school or go to work. God has something called on your life. God's calling you to be missionaries to what's around you. If you work, God has called you to do that. We have to put that trust that God's going to take care of us. This young boy with his lunch, I could just see the disciples, this little boy coming forward. What is this? What is this? And Jesus says, watch. I can take something small and make it great. You kids, that's pointed at you. He could take you, maybe you're little, even Mark. He can even take little crazy Mark, make him to be a giant in the faith. You're in your 60s, 70s, or 80s. God can still make you even mightier than you are in your faith. You have to trust Him. You have to give it to Him. If you're dealing with sickness or you have sickness in your family, someone's hurting, someone has cancer, think of my dear sister. I love her to death. God's going to touch her. God's going to work. Because, you know, I know her faith. God's amazing. We have to trust. We have to believe and have faith that God's going to move. When I pray to God, I always pray to God and ask Him that I'm expecting. I'm always praying to Him, I'm expecting to see something happen. Because it's not God's will for us to be hurting and dying and falling apart and all these things. God wants us to be close to Him. God wants us. I'd like the will to be rich. That'd be awesome if that could be my. But not all of us that way. God calls us each in different ways. I believe God has something for Becky, for my wife. They're raising our beautiful children. That's a ministry. Because let me tell you what I dealt with in school and what these kids are getting ready to come into is a totally different world, folks. So this morning, what I'm trying to get across, and what God has kind of revealed to me is trust Him. Trust Him. When everything else seems like it's going to fail, everything's just bearing down on you, put your trust in Jesus like the boy did. Like the woman who spent all of her living on physicians. Sometimes we need to have that faith in saying, we do need to go to the physician. I have to for me. But we need to also then pray to the Savior and say, Lord, give these physicians the knowledge and the know-how to take care of and do what you want them to do. God's calling us this morning. And I want to pass that along. I want to charge our congregation this morning. I got a lot of kids and a lot of teens. This is a charge for you as well. When you go back to school, or when you're at work, or you little guys, listen up. You guys go back to school. Have faith that God's with you guys. Trust Him when things seem rough, when there's maybe too much homework. Ask God to be with you. Ask for help. Trust Him. He's there with you guys. Trust your parents, guys. Go to your parents with things that are going on. I want us to think about this as we go on throughout our time, is to trust in God. This morning, I want to have that trust in Him, to know that no matter what happens, the pain that I have to deal with, the pain that my dear sister's going through, that God's going to be there and give them comfort, because He is. God loves each and every one of us. We were talking about this in the teens this morning, the teens Sunday school. I says, if I gave you 2 minutes, explain in a praise testimony what's so amazing about God. And we started talking about the attributes, His mercy. I think one was He was great. He's awesome. All these songs this morning that we've sung hit on that. We need to trust God with everything. If you're worried about bills, trust Him. If you're worried about your being sick, trust Him. If you're worried about going back to school, kids, trust Him. He's there with you. We have to have faith that our Lord, who died on a cross, who took my sins and buried them on the cross, that suffocated Him, that pulled Him down, is there with us. He loves each and every one of us enough to tell us that we have to have faith to trust that He's with us. I don't care how long you've been a Christian. Things come up and they make us doubt. They make us worry. They hurt us. He wants us to put that trust in Him and have faith that He is in control. Jesus is the answer to every problem. He's not just the answer to, guess what, we're going to heaven. No, He's the answer. And maybe if you have marriage problems, He's the answer. If you have finance problems, He's the one that has the answers for you kids if you're dealing with bullying. He's the answer. He can get you through, guys. God has to be the number one in our lives. We have to trust Him with everything. If that means doctors, what they're going to do when we're sick. If that means, Lord, I pray the wages I get me through. I've seen amazing things happen. You think you don't have enough, and all of a sudden a check comes in the mail. You pay too much on something. Our God is amazing. We have to trust Him in our lives, guys. Each and every one of us, if you're a deacon, guess what? We have to trust Him, don't we, Gary? If you're a trustee, you have to trust Him. We have to trust that God is going to take care of us. So if you're dealing with something this morning, I want you to close your eyes and I want you to just say a prayer to Him and say, Lord, I trust You this morning. And I want you to deep down believe it with all your heart, because we have to trust the King of Kings. Government is not going to save us. They're not going to buy us out. The church is not going to help us and buy us out. Only one person hand who works through that church is Jesus Christ. We have to trust that Jesus is in control before we can start thinking about anything. There's days I don't really can get out of bed because of the pain, but I have trust in Him that He's going to get me through that. I have trust that God's going to get me through. If I have to go to the hospital, give the doctor hopefully the right antibiotic this time. We have to trust God in everything in our lives. Now, kids, when you guys are growing up, I want you guys to remember this. God can use you. He wants to use you, Madison. He wants to use you, Jason. He wants to use you, Blake. He wants to touch you and use you guys for the ministry to maybe share with somebody else who's hurting and dying. That's why Celebrate Recovery is a great ministry, because it gives us the opportunity to share and say, guess what? There was a time I didn't trust like I needed to, but I'm trusting Him now, and God's amazing. It's not all smooth sailing, is it, Gary? It's not all smooth sailing either, because guess what? You're still going to hurt your back. You're still going to have pain. You're still going to have arthritis. Boy, I can't wait for that day when we go to heaven and that's gone, right? I can't wait for that day when we cross over and we see this beautiful heaven and we see Jesus. No more tears, no more sorrow, no pain. I don't think there'll be painful tears. I think there's going to be tears of joy. There's going to be tears of joy because we're going to see the King who died for us, who loved us. We have to put that trust in our life on Him. Like the woman did, as she just knelt down. I could see her in the crowd, everything around, and she just had to touch that garment. And Jesus felt it, believe Him. He felt the faith. He felt the trust. This morning, we need to have that faith and trust and touch that garment this morning. That no matter what we're going through, God's there with us. Touch the garment this morning and trust. Have that power come within you. Ask the Holy Spirit to show you. Ask the Holy Spirit to give you a double portion this morning. Get you excited like this crazy preacher with a limp. Have the Holy Spirit just touch you this morning. If you're dealing with so many things, we have so much. Each and every one of us can write a book about our lives, right? All the crazy things that have happened. I think your brother Rick shared his testimony with me before. And how God has pulled him through all the stuff he's been through. What God's pulled me through. You guys have a story. Trust the King of Kings this morning. And I'm going to say this. If you need someone to pray with you this morning, you can come down right now. I'll stop and I'll start praying. We are a family of God. I want you guys to trust Him. I want to have more trust. Because Brother Josh knows, last time I was in the hospital, I had a low point. I'll say it. Because guess what? I'm a weak human who doesn't have all the strength that I can have. I was having a downtime. Don't understand it. All I'm hearing is doctors say, chop that toe off. Take it off. And my spirit was down. I needed to hear it from you, brother. I needed to hear. Maybe somebody in here this morning needs somebody to call them. Maybe somebody in your family needs to hear a phone call saying, we love you. Trust in God. He's right there with you. We'll pray together. Teenagers, I want you guys to have trust in God. I want you guys to be able to, when we walk out of this church house, we go to Walmart, we can start witnessing and not be afraid to, because we can trust God. Kids, I want you guys to be excited about coming to church on Sunday so we can get to meet the Savior. So this morning, as we get close to the end, that's a preacher's trick too, by the way. Usually that just means he's rallying back up. This morning, I want everybody right now, just close your eyes for just a second. close your eyes for just a second. And I want you guys to think about something that you need more trust, you need more faith in. Maybe it's your finances. Maybe it's your marriage needs more prayer. Maybe it's your children that are lost. Maybe it's something in your lives that's just been overwhelming. And you need a touch from God this morning. I want us to picture that thing that's in our lives that's happening. Think about your loved one. Kids, I want you guys to think about in school. I want you guys to think about how God can take control of it. How about what happens when we take that lunch and we give it to Jesus and He takes it and does something mighty with it? I'm going to pray real quick. I'm going to pray over our congregation and then we'll get ready for close. But think about that person. Think about that thing that you're needing help with this morning. The thing that you need to put trust in. Let's pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to You this morning with our eyes closed, our heads bowed, and we're thinking of something that we're needing help with, Lord. We need more truth. We need more trust. We need more faith. We need more of You, Jesus. Lord, this morning I'm praying for everyone here in our congregation that somebody or something on their heart this morning. Lord God, touch them. Give them a peace this morning. Lord God, give them that pull of trust deep down in their soul to know that You've got this. Like the little boy who just gave his lunch. Lord God, we're trusting this morning that You're going to move and You're going to touch these things. And we're going to wait and see how amazing You are through these things that You're going to do. So Lord God, as we close this prayer and we get ready to sing our final songs, Lord God, I pray that You move amongst our people here this morning, that we can have that faith and we can have that trust to be able to conquer the mountain, to be able to march right through Satan's armies and laugh with them and say they've done lost. So this morning as we close in prayer, Lord, I'm expecting to see and I'm expecting to hear some amazing stories, Lord God, of how You've worked and how You've done some things in our folks' lives. And Lord, I'm going to say this like I always say. Lord God, I thank You in advance for what You're going to do for everyone here and for our churches around us. Lord, I pray for all the people around us that are hurting that we can get that trust and that faith to get on fire for You to touch their lives. So Lord, I'm thankful for what You're going to do. We ask Your Son's precious name. Amen. Love and trust. God's got it, guys. God's got it. He's in control. Are you willing to surrender all this morning? This morning has been, it's touched my heart. I always say when I preach it more for myself than I do for you folks, because God says I need it.